Hey y'all, I'm Jody Wolfborn, one of the senior curriculum developers at Chef Software, and this is the first video in a series I'm working on called Getting Started with Habitat. In this first video, Core Concepts, I'll cover what Habitat is from a high level, talk about some of its important components, and briefly describe how its built-in capabilities allow software engineers to build, deploy, and manage applications in a modern way. If you're already familiar with what Habitat is, check out the other videos in this series to configure your workstation, create a plan for your app, or start playing around in the studio. From the website, Habitat is open source software that creates platform-independent build artifacts and provides built-in deployment and management capabilities. What that means is you can efficiently modernize your applications without reinventing the wheel, keep modern and legacy apps up to date in an ever-changing customer landscape, and gain platform and environment flexibility without painting yourself into a corner when new trends emerge. To demonstrate why this is important, it's probably best to start by describing what legacy application means. For the context of this video, legacy apps are business-critical applications that are built for longevity. That's a nice way of saying inflexible software solutions that are obsolete, outdated, or tied to a specific platform or practice. In other words, it works on this specific operating system in this specific environment as long as everything is perfect and the wind is blowing norwesterly and the Seattle storm are still winning. The reason engineers groan so collectively when the term legacy is thrown around is because legacy apps tend to decrease the efficiency of your development pipeline while increasing the rate of breakages and severely stifling the speed at which you can get changes or net new features out to production. In the age of social media and instant gratification, getting new features out to customers needs to be quick and painless, and legacy apps don't tend to play well with quick and painless. They usually require specific runtime and build time services to work, which means historically they've been tied to a specific operating system or platform, and updating legacy apps to work with newer versions of those platforms or systems can be painstaking, to put it gently. The pyramid on the left side of this diagram represents the historical approach to application development, where an engineer, usually an ops person, spins up the required operating system, installs any needed libraries, run and build time dependencies, and then makes sure that any app-specific libraries and dependencies are installed before handing it over to the developer to do their thing. The developer makes their changes, tests, and then hopefully commits that code back to a repo. But if the developer has made any changes to the underlying dependencies as part of this process, those changes are lost when the test system is spun down. Or if you're running RHEL 6 in production because that's what you're licensed for, but CentOS 7 in test because it's free and it's the same anyway, isn't it? Then you get that ever faithful meme, "It worked on my machine." On the other side of the diagram, we see how Habitat flips this paradigm on its head. With Habitat, you can package all of your application's service layer dependencies along with its runtime and build time dependencies in a single artifact that can be deployed to whatever operating system makes sense in whatever environment makes sense. This flexibility means people working with legacy systems can still modernize while avoiding bulky, high-risk rewrites of their code base, and people working with more flexible, modern applications can gain agility and maintain relevance to current industry trends. Now all the things your application needs to survive in the real world are packaged with your application, giving you flexibility to deploy it on bare metal, cloud images, or containers, and onto whatever operating system makes sense for your business. There are a few major components that allow Habitat to work in this way, and the first is called the plan. Engineers can use a plan to describe the behavior and configuration of their running applications or packages. Habitat then uses the plan to verify your package's origin, validate the checksum of any source code that needs to be downloaded, build and install the libraries or binaries your app needs, and then package everything, including dependencies and assets, in a compressed tarball signed with your origin's key. This package is called a habitat artifact, or a heart file for short. Once packaged, heart files can be exported into a number of different formats, including TAR, Docker, Mesos, ACI, Cloud Foundry, Kubernetes, and Helm. When you run the package, Habitat uses a built-in supervisor to start, stop, and manage your application in a variety of topologies and with some pretty sweet capabilities. You can use the supervisor to deploy your app into a gossip ring, a leader-follower topology, join it to an overarching service group, remotely apply configuration updates and upload new files to your service, and even define different deployment strategies. The last component of Habitat that I want to talk about is the Studio. In addition to helping you modernize and automate your applications, the Habitat command line interface provides you with a clean room studio where you can deploy your app locally with all of its dependencies. Within the Studio, you can build new features, make changes, and test your application code in a safe environment. And from there, you can deploy it out to various build channels, where the supervisor will authenticate your signed packages and deploy it out to your running applications using whatever deployment strategy you've defined. So to sum up, by wrapping Habitat around any of your applications, modern or legacy, you get a quick and easy way to start building, deploying, and managing your apps in a modern, more flexible way. For a quick guide on how to get your workstation configured with the Hab CLI, watch the next video in this series, Getting Started with Habitat, a Practitioner's Guide. And go to habitat.sh for more documentation and some online tutorials. Until next time, I'm Jody Wolfborn. Bye!